Tayo pa lang magdalawa?
Tayo pa lang, yes.
Kumusta na po yung ano nyo? Yung namamaga pa buhay pa nyo?
Hindi na, okay na. Galing na.
Ano pong tawag doon? Strombolosis ba yun?
Hindi eh, ano. Gout brought by yung medicine na ininom ko. Tapos may pinahid ako dun sa gout. Nagkaroon allergic reaction na maga yung buong katawan ko.
Oh my God!
Mula ulo hanggang paa.
So, nagka-allergy.
Allergy. Yung mukha ko umalsa. Para akong sinapak ni Pacquiao.
Antibiotics po ba yan o ano?
Ano?
Antibiotics, no?
Ano kasi ako eh. Allergic ako sa ibuprofen.
Yung ano, aspirin.
Yun, allergic ako. So, namamaga yung mata ko, yung lips ko.
Tinanong ko po na sa kuya ko, sabi ko, kabatch mo ba si Jeff Guiwa? Sabi niya, no, ahead siya sa AIM. Ahead siya sa akin ng 2 or 3 years yata. Sabi niya, brother ko, nag-aaral din sa AIM.
Oh, saan? Sa Pilipinas?
Aha.
Sa Asian Institute of Management?
Yes.
Oh, talaga.
Sabi niya, kabatch, I mean, ahead siya sa akin ng 3 years to pa, sabi niya. Sabi niya, pero ano daw, kasi kukunti lang ata kayo dun eh, so alam niya yung pangalan.
Saan kayo sa Pilipinas?
Sa Cubao.
Oh, Cubao lang ah. Diyan ako pinanganak, sa Murphy.
Ah, sa Murphy. Sa Murphy rin kami ako, inano eh. Campan, ano yun? Panopio ba yun?
Campaginaldo?
Oh, Campaginaldo Hospital.
Ako sa ano, sa Ortanias Hospital ako pinanganak. Diyan sa may Aurora Boulevard.
Ah, Ortanias?
Noon, may Ortanias pa. Sa may Aurora Boulevard.
Meron ba doon?
Wala na ngayon yun.
Meron po sila, alam ko sa ano na eh, sa Ortanias. Sa may... sa Aurora Boulevard, malapit sa Cubao.
Yeah, malapit sa Project 4, St. Joseph Church. Yeah.
Yung St. Joseph, ano pa yata yun? Ano pa yata?
Oh, St. Joseph Church. Oh, boy pa yun.
Oh, St. Joseph. Marami pa rin nagnunabina.
Nung lumindol, nilakad ko yun. Mula UST hanggang St. Joseph Church. Ang layo.
Wow, layo. Mga kalahating araw.
Wala masakyan na ni Lindol.
Inabot ko rin yun eh. Inabot ko rin yung ganung klaseng, yung strike ang mga jeep.
Ako yun yung 1990 earthquake yun.
1990 earthquake, nasa 11th floor ako ng building.
Mm-hmm.
Akala ko guguho na yung building. Sabi ko, katapusan ko na.
I know.
Tapos, doon ko nakita na habang bumababa ako sa hagdan. Kasi ang mali ko namin, dapat umakyat pa kami sa 12th floor. Kasi yun yung penthouse.
Mm-hmm.
Ang nangyari, bumaba kami. Nagpanik eh. Ako yung sinusunda nila.
Mm-hmm.
Sabi nung... Kasi may naglakas loob doon. Labas tayo sa building last. Di sabi, malapit ako sa fire exit. Dumaan ako sa fire exit pababa. Mm-hmm. Ang lindol noon, yung dribble. Nagdi-dribble, hindi siya swing. So, nakita ko, inahabol kami ng crack ng pader. Pababa, tapos umuusok, nahuhulog yung mga buhangin.
Uh-huh.
Para talagang ano, end of the world sa akin. Tapos, lumilindol pa rin hanggang pagbaba. Tapos nakita ko nagkakaroon ng crack yung mga yung sa Paseo de Rojas, yung mga pavement. Nagsiswing yung mga bintana ng mga ano, ng mga building. Tapos nababasag, nahuhulog. Hindi pa uso nun yung pino ang pagbagsak eh. Mm-hmm. Yung mga sharp pa.
Yeah, yeah.
Na salamin. Ala! Para kang nasa movie nun.
Hey, Pastor Berg, good morning.
Good morning, Pastor.
Or
naking pasok?
Na ngayon, salamat. Binigyan ako ng
break. Pay off. Mayaman, mayaman yung kumpanya niya eh.
Ano yun? Essential. Essential yun.
Ano yun? Frontliner yan sa pasal birthday.
Oo. Hindi yan masasara. Bawal isara.
Buti na lang. Maaga kami kapon. Kaya ano, independence eh. Siguro na.
Ang dami nagpapaputo kagabi.
Oo, oh, dami.
Usual eh. Usual, di ba every 4th of July, meron lang isang area pinagbawal. Ngayon, nagpapaputok lahat ng tao. parang Pilipinas eh.
Talagang ano.
Parang Maynila lang.
Kala ko, ano, buti pang sinabi ng governor eh, isa na lang lugar eh.
Good morning, Pastor Manny. Good morning, Sister Fe.
Hello, good morning.
Morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Good
morning. Still, wrong spelling yung Maranan, Maranak.
Oo nga eh. Ako din, madalas magkamali dun eh. Ang saya dito kagabi, Pastor.
Oo nga po eh, nakita ko nga sa TV.
Kabi-kabila, puro fireworks, saka lalakas ng putukan.
Parang Maynila.
Oo, parang Pinas.
Nina, mga bandang alas 5, alas 6, parang nasa Baguio ko eh kasi ang maraming ulap, ngayon pala usok.
Pero ano pa yan, Pastor? Friday night pa lang, nag-umpisa na dito.
Yung usok, makikita mo pa. Smag eh, kung hindi...
Amoy pulburo na.
Mm.
Kasi pinagbawal na magkaroon ng gathering. So, ginawa ng lahat. Nagkanya-kanyang paputok. So, parang naging Metro Manila New Year.
Mm-hmm. Tama.
Dito lang sa Valley. Mm. Mga kapitbahay namin, nagpapaputok lahat eh.
Hello?
Oh. Yeah.
Oh, yan. Sa aming ego, gano'n rin.
Pati yung paputok, nag-social distancing. Kasi nagsabay-sabay.
Ano pa, sir?
Yung paputok po, nag-social distancing kasi nagsabay-sabay.
Oo nga. Hindi, dito sa amin, Pastor, kabi-kabila hanggang bubong, meron putukan hanggang alas 12.
Oh.
Kasi malapit na kami sa Grand Park, kaya kitang-kita eh.
Ah, yeah, yeah, yeah. O, dyan ang ano, sentro.
Pero yung Elysian Park, nasunog ah.
Ay, gano'n.
Alen?
Elysian Park.
Suno?
Kasi siguro ginawa sa park yung fireworks, so doon nagliyab. Pero hindi na nagagapan din, pero may nasunog.
Hmm.
Kagabi.
Good morning, sir. Good morning.
Kagabi rin natatakot ako kasi yung mga putukan, yung mga paputok, nandito sa paligid namin eh.
Mm-hmm.
Hindi mismo
baka mamalingan ng mga...
Nag-suportable na yata. Kasi lahat dito, pati sa amin dito, buong kanya-kanyang bahay. Mabuto.
Oo, yun na eh.
Ang polis, bumunta eh. Wala nilang magawa eh. Next time for a while, tapos yun na naman, putok na. Ay, nako. Nasunog pa yung ano, yung kahoy dito. Isang puno. Pumunta ang fire truck.
Oh.
Sa harap ng bahay namin. Buti naman na agapan.
Mabuti ka, wala ngayon dyan mga sunog-sunog sa mga gubat-gubat.
Meron dito sa Guadulce the other day, mga Thursday.
Oh, meron pa rin.
Na-put off ka agad.
Ano na eh,
mainit na eh, nag-spark lang eh. Kaya bantayan mo yung mga freeway, lagi dyan may nag-spark.
Ah, may answered prayer ako. Ay, answered prayer ako, Pastor.
Hindi po.
Yung si Faith, nakakatulog na siya ng 9 hours. Tapos, in-advise siya ng psychiatrist magpa-thyroid test. Normal naman daw lahat. Siguro, talaga anxiety lang. So,
it's all in the mind.
Oo. Oo, okay na. Ngayon, ang kanyang hobby, gardening.
Okay, that's good.
Oo. Sabi niya, ewan ko kung kailan ako babalik ng Los Baños. Kasi nga, nag-online classes na sila.
Mm.
Sabi ko, wag na muna bumalik doon, tapos mag-iisa na naman siya doon.
Mm. Sino pa? Then, si Pastor Norbert na dyan na, oh. Tita Fe, huwag nagko-connect si Tita Fe. Who else ang nag-join? Si Ten people.
Oh. Si ano kaya? Maka-join si Elvi? Si Elvi? Mr. Bert.
Amo. Good morning po.
Si Elvi kaya maka-join sa ating prayer meeting. Last time.
May ano siya.
Nga, prepare po siguro yung ano ng ano niya. Alaga niya.
Okay.
Sabi niya kasi usually daw 9 o'clock pastor gumigising yung pasyente niya so hindi niya maiwan.
Patulogin nila pag hindi joke. Joke lang.
Pastor, ay ano na kain?
Para po tayo ni.
Sabi sabi ko, ang ano mo sa po pagkain? Ah, kain lang kain pero kuno kumikita siya doon. Oo. Tapos kaya asarap pala.
Kumain siya, no? Ay, testimony ko muna.
Sino yun?
Si Tita Pedro mo kang may background.
Tita
good morning, Tita Fe.
Pastor.
Yeah, Tita Fe.
Oh. Pupunta ako sa bathroom. Kasi sa bathroom. Maingay dito kasi nag-ano po, kumustahan sila.
Okay.
Yeah, dito na ako sa bus.
Literal na ano.
Ako, hindi makagamit. Hindi sila makagamit na isang oras.
Hindi. Ngayon lang sila nag-meet. Kaya maingay. Nandito
lang. Ah, okay.
May noise pa ba, Pastor?
Wala na, okay na.
Nandito ako sa bathroom. Umuupo ako dito sa dito ako sa bathroom.
Ang prayer room mo.
Maingay sila eh. Ngayon lang kasi sila nakita.
Di ba kasi biblical po yan. Nasa closet kayo nagpe-pray.
Tama yan ako. Tama-tama.
Kasi Father Bong, ha?
Good morning, Father Bong.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Parang natanggap mo yung memo, Brother Bong, na magbublu tayo ngayon.
Oh. Naka-blu din ako. Si Girly kaya pa mag-a-attend?
Patinan mo.
Ha? Girly. Permitting. Starting.
Okay, so sino pa ba mga ano pa ang dinista mo dito prayer request? Ministry, pandemic, personal supplication, yeah. Okay.
Gusto pa nila. Bago tayo magsimula mag-pray, testimony. Ganda ng testimony, Tita Fe, para sa anak niya.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay.
Thank you sa prayer.
Hello. Brother Bong, may testimony, Goro.
Sa akin, Pastor. Yung one pastor, yung sa akin eh, yung continued guidance ni Lord sa trabaho ko dahil very stressful. Every day, kakainitan ba? Nakarinig kayo ng cursing, lalo ni amo ko. Yeah. I thank God dahil yung may isa akong inspector, yung parang head inspector, Christian siya, siya yung kausap ko. Doon, sharing kami. Encouragement. So I thank God na kahit na papano, kahit na gano'n yung environment, may kasama pa rin akong Christian na kwan ba? Pwede akong mag-share ng concern ko. So, minsan pinag-tortay pa niya ako. So, I thank God for
very good. Ang galing. That's good.
Mm-hmm. Any prayer request, testimony, mga kapatid?
Prayer request ko, Pastor, for my chest x-ray tomorrow. Maging okay.
X-ray.
Yeah. Tsaka, okay. Pastor, yung ano, protection pa rin sa building namin kasi na-confirm, meron na raw 5 COVID patients sa 16th floor. Sa 15th floor ako. So, pumapasok na daw yung mga COVID na yun. Sabi nila. Kaya protection lang sa building.
Ano lang, Fe, continue, sanitize everything. Wash your hands. Don't put your hands in your face. Yun lang. Kahit nandyan yung virus, hindi yun papasok until you have the common sense.
Face mask. Mahalaga rin yung face mask.
Face mask din. Ang ako naman, thank you sa prayers and sa kapatid ko. Yung stent niya, si very successful. Okay na siya.
Oh, okay.
To pray for Madel. Si Madel nag-undergo ng chemo. This is the fourth. So hopefully, after the sixth, maka-ano na siya, recover. Mm. And then, si nanay ngayon has renal infection, kaya hindi na maiwanan. Lagi nasa bed. Nagkakaroon na siya ng frequent UTI dahil yung barrier ng bladder niya, nagninipis na masyado ng manipis. So, most likely, ang probability ng infection is very, ano, very frequent. So, we have to go and see another doctor specialized sa urology, yun sa ano mismo sa bladder niya. Yun lang. So, tomorrow, I'll have a doctor.
Pero okay pa naman si nanay.
Oh, yeah. I mean, this COVID na hindi lumalabas eh. Parang ano, lalong nalalanta
eh. Oo nga eh, totoo yun.
Walang, ano, walang... Ha?
Yung bang Madel, yung ba yung pamangkin mo?
Asawa ng pamangkin ni ko, si Francis, yeah.
Ah, okay, okay.
Pamangkin ko yun.
Iba yung pamangkin mo, no?
Yung pamangkin ko si Adasa. Oh, okay,
ah, si Adasa.
Okay, si Adasa, ano na yan, frequent and check-up. Hmm.
Oh,
pero
that's good.
May mga si takot nga lumabas kasi, di ba? Ano siya? Immunosuppressed. Ang immune system niya talagang very low. Baka...
So, hindi siya nagtatrabaho ngayon?
Sa bahay. Dito.
Sa bahay lang. Oo, that's
bahay
good.
Lang. Bahay lang talaga. Hindi pwedeng lumabas.
Mm-hmm.
Prayer request, testimony, Sister Lenlen.
Ano po? Kasi yung sa akin naman yung kasi sa office namin downtown. So marami nang nagiging desperate na homeless. Inaatake nila yung building. Mm-hmm. Eh nasa ground floor kami. So binabato, nilulusob. Mm-hmm. Sa isang araw, sumatawag kami ng mga dalawang beses ng police. Yung peace ng surrounding.
Ano kasi inabuso kasi ng California ang police force natin kaya they demean the ano yung integrity ng mga police kaya nagkakaroon ng ganyang resentment ang mga police at saka yung resentment ng mga homelessness. So talagang the devil is trying to disrupt and disturb actually the whole world. I think this is now awakening na kailangan natin talaga ng spiritual warfare. Kailangan maging offensive, remember taking up the authority God has given us. I think we are to engage talaga sa warfare. Kasi pag hindi, siya ang naunguna lagi, yung demonyo.
Amen.
So we really have to guard ourselves. Remember, Ephesians 6, put on the full armor of God. Lagi yan, command yung Panginoon.
Mm-hmm.
Every day, we really have to do it.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Pastor Bert, any testimony, any...
Yeah. Salamat po. Yeah, Pastor, thank you. Yun nga, yung miracle. kahit na hindi ako nagre-request, yun nga, yung Sunday na nalibre ako, sana hindi na magbago yung schedule.
That's good.
Kaya lang, maglilib na naman yung isa, kaya mag-schedule na naman. So, very ano, hindi permanent yung schedule namin. Pero mostly closing ako. Kaya yung mga gabi natin, hindi ako nakapag-attend.
Mm-hmm.
Pag-pray din lang po yung mga minsan na ako yung nakapro. Merong mga, yun din, yung sabi din, merong nakikipag-away. Merong mga matigas na ulo. Kaya lang, kailangan ko rin yung face shield ko. Kahit na nakamasa ko, naka-face shield pa rin. Kasi yung mga homeless na sa Pinoy, minsan kumakain sa loob. Pagkatapos ako yung naka-front sa kanila, humahabol, nakikipag-usap. Talagang, ano sila, yung violent sila pag nakikipag-usap. Kahapon, yun nga, meron na naman akong na-encounter. Sabi niya, huwag mo kong iduro. Iduro, sabi niya. isa na, nasa matino pero ano, talagang out of ano na sila. So, yun po yung sitwasyon minsan. Minsan lang naman yun eh. Yung safety lang sa market.
Mm-hmm.
And siguro po yung ano, yung trabaho ni James, kasi nag-resign na siya kasi namatay nga yung tinrain niyang nurse. Then yung management, tanggap ng tanggap, hindi sila iniintindi. So yun po, nag-resign yung anak ko sa trabaho niya. So hoping makapaganap siya ng ano, maganda yung management na mapapasukan niya.
Mm-hmm. Good morning.
COVID din po kasi yung lugar nila, yung ano nila.
Opo. Good morning, Sister Eloy.
Good morning po, Sisid po.
Good morning.
Sabi lang po ng konti. Habang kumakain po yung anak.
Tita Fe, any testimony or any grace report or any prayer request?
Request ko, Pastor, yung God will cover, will protect my grandchildren. All of them are on the front line. So, si yung isa, one of them, got sick. Pero, okay naman, gumaling na siya ngayon.
Amen.
Pero I'm requesting a prayer for all covering, protection for all of them. Yun ang ano concern ko ngayon, Pastor.
Apo.
Thank you so much.
Amen. Thank you. Sister LV, any prayer request or any testimony would you like to share before we start? Yan, baka nagpapa...
Ako po.
Apo.
Oh, prayer request daw.
Ano po, si yung aking alaga. Kasi meron po siyang ano, aklesia. It's a problem, a swallowing problem po.
Muscle yan sa throat na.
Oo, sa may throat po siya.
So, ang throat muscle niya, hindi na
yung muscles po niya nag-construct para pong lumalaki pag kumakain siya. Hmm. So, kailangan talaga may bantay.
Oh, soft diet yan, kailangan.
Oo po, yung diet po niya, yun ang binabantayan ko. Kaya po, pag kumakain siya, hindi ko po siya maiwan. Kailangan pinapakinggan ko po talaga.
Oo.
O, kasi baka ma-choke siya.
Ma-choke yan. Oo.
So, yung pong aklesia niya, so, pag-pray po natin na ma-lessen po yung ano, yung kasi lumalaki po talaga after niyang kumain, parang yung goiter.
Ilang taon na siya?
96. Magda 96 na po siya sa November, pero hindi po siya pwedeng, ayaw po niya ng Botox.
Mm-hmm.
Yung pong meron silang i-inject sa nerve mo para yung for 6 months lang po yun para yung nerve niya hindi po siya ma-stress o yung muscles niya dyan hindi ma-stress para ma-ano mm-hmm. lang po. So ayaw po niya kasi meron daw pong danger dahil sa edad niya.
Tama.
So ganun na lang
daw po. Mahirap na rin yung ganyang mga edad eh. You can't really...
So, kaya hindi ko po siya maiwanan. Kaya po pag nag-ano tayo in the morning, so kailangan ko po talaga umaalis. Nawawala na lang po akong bigla kasi inuubos siya pag minsan. So pagkipag-pray na lang po na ma-ano po niya ma-overcome po niya yung ganon.
Amen.
Okay. Yung prayer request ko yung ating meeting this Friday, we will be sharing about the vision.
Mm-hmm.
The vision natin and your relationship with the MCP, please. We hope that a lot of members will be joining us. So please contact them during the week. I hope they will respond positively. Mm-hmm. Share lang natin ng gusto about why we need them para makita nila what we need to do. So please pray for that. Also, please pray for our mag-reopen na kami ng Bible study and Sunday service. Saturday service sa Silmar. Doon sa 4th Street, Church of the Nazarene. So, you're invited to join us.
Friday, what time? 7?
Friday, 7 o'clock doon.
Saturday.
And Saturday, 4 o'clock.
4:30.
So, this Friday, medyo malate lang ko sa ating meeting online. Pastor Jeff will be the one to start the meeting and then susunod na lang ako depende sa pagkatapos.
Ako mag-drive. Ikaw mag-drive.
Mm-hmm. Ang ganda. Sige.
Pastor, may tanong lang po ako.
Mm-hmm.
Kagabi si Sister Ada, hindi niya alam yung pag-ano ng Zoom. Pwede po siyang paano po yun? Pwede niyong padala yung icon or what?
Download yun sa phone, Pastor. She has to go to her app Store?
Oh, yung app na banggit
ko. Oh, App Store. Tapos search mo yung Zoom. And then i-download mo. Yun na. Pwede ka Zoom, na mag-join.
Zoom lang po yun. Zoom. Wala nang ibang ano.
Wala. Zoom. Yung parang video icon.
Okay. Siguro po, gagawa ko ng instruction.
Tawagan namin. Oh, gawa namin yung instruction padalan.
Gagawa tayo ng instructional video tapos ipopost natin doon sa mga...
Yeah, tama, Pastor.
Sa thread
natin. Pati si Suset yata walang Zoom eh.
Pati sister si Suset,
wala.
Kailangan rin niya instructional video.
Yeah. So instructional pati video si, para lahat makasama.
Pati si Edward.
Yeah, tapos sisendan natin sila lahat. Okay, so good morning po sa... Meron po tayong apat na prayer focus for this morning. Number one, kaya po tayo merong prayer breakfast. Ang unang-una na, ang pinakatalagang goal natin ay pag-pray. Yung focus, yung ministry natin. Walk by Faith, Church of the Nazarene. Parang ang saya-saya ng lahat na may pakiramdam na malaya. Anano. So,
tama, July, 4th of July, anniversary natin yan.
4th of July na may independence.
Independence Day natin. 4th of parang July.
Na-enjoy ko yung meeting nung last Friday eh. Parang nakangiti lahat eh. Anyway, yung pinaka first and foremost reason talaga natin why we meet and pray every Sunday morning is focus on our ministry. Kasi prayer without a ministry without prayer, walang backbone yun. So we need to push talaga yung ministry natin. So top one priority natin while praying every Sunday, yung ministry natin. So ang prayer leader natin for today, sa magpipray about our ministry, about our meeting on Friday, about our directions, about everything that will happen in our ministry will be Brother Bong. So he will pray for it like 2 to 3 minutes or whatever. Ano. And then, to be followed by number two, ang second focus naman natin, what's happening in the world, particularly sa country natin, kagaya ng Pilipinas at saka ng US. Dito, merong racism problem, merong pandemic problem, election problem, divisiveness problem. So, let's pray for that. Pray for the Philippines. Whatever mga nangyayari doon, yung pandemic din, yung economy and everything. So, the prayer leader for that would be Sister Te Maranan. And number three, we will pray for the pandemic. Itong pinakamalaki nating problema ngayon sa buong mundo. So, from healing, from everything na matutunan natin dito, so we will be by Sister Fe Rumok about praying for the pandemic. Tapos I will pray for all, in number four, focus natin, I will pray for all your personal requests. And then Pastor Manny will wrap up our prayer. Galing na ba kayo? Nakuha niyo po? So si Brother Bong muna, we will pray for the world, our ministry. Then to be followed by Sister Fe Maranan. About the world, country, government, leaders, election, and everything that is happening. Number three, another Sister Fe, Dumuk. She will pray about pandemic. Tama, nasa closet si Sister Fe Dumuk ngayon. So.
Hindi. Pastor, nandito na ako sa gazebo. Magandang nasa lugar ko dito. Yeah. Ako lang sa...
Nasa prayer garden na. So.
Nandito na ako sa gazebo.
May progress.
Then I will pray for all the personal requests. And then Pastor Manny will wrap up our prayer. So,
okay.
Na ba kayo? Manalangin tayo?
Yes.
Okay, let's put ourselves in the presence of the Lord. Let's worship Him. Hallelujah. Brother Bong, you may start whenever you're ready.
Tayo manalangin.
Hallelujah.
Kami po'y lubos na nagpapasalamat sa inyong paggabay sa amin, Lord God. Sa simbahan, Lord, thank you for guiding us through those decisions regarding our exit from MCB and in reallocating our resources, Lord God, for your different ministries, Lord. Lord, we lift up you, our different ministries, especially the evangelism, Lord God, that we could reach more people, Lord God.
Yes.
Also,
yes.
To open up more Bible study groups, Lord. Mm-hmm. Lord, you know that you would be with us in this an undertaking, Lord God. You would completely, you would guide us, Lord God. Lord, we pray that you would give us wisdom sa mga adhikain namin, Panginoon, sa pagpursu, Lord God, ng vision ng church, Lord God, to reach more people, Lord God, the lost ones, Lord, to bring to your kingdom, Lord. Lord, we ask for your guidance. We ask for your strength, Lord God, especially this time of pandemic, Lord God, so you would keep us safe, Lord God. And pray, Lord God, always for your deliverance, Lord, masasamang environment, Lord God. And also, Lord God, kayong manguna sa aming mga decision, Lord God. May you always be glorified, Lord, in whatever we do. We ask this in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Thank you. Sister Femaranan, kindly unmute yourself. Thank you. Sister Fe, kindly unmute yourself.
Okay, good morning. Heavenly Father, we praise and thank you for this wonderful morning, for the good weather, for waking us up, each and every one of us, oh Lord. You said in your word, oh Lord, that we should not stop meeting together because by doing so, we are encouraging one another as we look up in the future, oh Lord, at sa paligid namin, Lord, sa nangyayari sa mundo ngayon. Lord, we do not know what's happening in the world. We do not know, Lord, when this pandemic will come to an end. We do not know, Lord, what the future holds for us. Pero naniniwala po kami, Lord, na you are the one who's in control of everything. The devil is just around, always around, waiting to devour everything, oh Lord. But we believe, oh Lord, you are taking care of us, oh Lord. Hindi po kami pababayaan, Panginoon. Lord, ang mundo ngayon magulo. Marami silang focus sa kanilang mga finances. Natatakot po sila ngayon dahil hindi nila alam kung hanggang kailan itong pandemic nito. But we trust you, oh Lord. We believe that you will not leave us nor forsake us, oh Lord. Lord, kayo po ang bahala sa amin. Kayo niniwala po kami, Lord, na you are in control of everything. Na may purpose po, Lord, bakit po nangyayari ang pandemic na ito, na marami po ngayon, Lord, lumalayo sa inyo, nandyan po, Lord, ang mga antichrist working around, oh Lord, para kunin po kami, Panginoon, pero hindi po kami bibigay. Nasa inyo lamang po kami, Panginoon. I lift up to you, Lord, ang buong mundo, lahat ng mga countries na nasa pandemic. Hipuin niyo po ang mga tao, Lord, na magbalik loob sa inyo. Dahil naniniwala po kami, Lord, na kayo lamang po ang aming sandigan, O Lord. Marami pong mga false prophets, marami pong false preachers na nagtuturo, O Lord, ng hindi po nasang-ayon sa inyong kautusan, O Lord. So we pray, O Lord, that these leaders, Lord, mawala po sila, Lord. Kayo po ang humipo sa kanila, Lord, sa mga tao sa buong mundo. Na, Lord, maging obedient po sila, Lord, sa mga leaders namin, especially yung paggamit ng mga mask, yung social distancing, hanggang ngayon po, Lord, maraming nag-aaway dahil ayaw po nilang sumunod. Sa mga sa groceries, sa mga supermarket, ang dami po, Lord, nagbabatuhan, nagagalit, naninira, dahil naniniwala sila na hindi sila naniniwala, Lord, sa pandemic na nangyayari ngayon. We lift up to you all the people who are on the streets, yung mga homeless people, Lord. We pray, O Lord, ingatan niyo rin po sila, Lord, at maintindihan nila hindi po basta-basta ang nangyayari sa mundo. We lift up to you the Philippines. Ang presidente po, Lord, marami pong nagagalit sa kanya. Hindi po nila alam. Hindi po namin alam, Lord, kung ano ang effect nitong anti-terrorism bill na ginagawa niya, Lord. But in the end, Lord, alam po namin may purpose ito, Lord. Basta i-guide nyo lang po, Lord, ang aming mga presidente, ang mga leaders, ang mga nasa Senado, ang mga tao na against the government, ang mga tao na with the government, Lord. We pray, Lord, na magkaisa ang mga tao sa Pilipinas, Lord. Kasi kayo, dahil sa pagkakaisa nito, Lord, maayos po ang sitwasyon ng Pilipinas. Lalo na ang leadership ni President Duterte, Lord. Ipuin niyo po ang presidente namin kasi sa ngayon nakikita namin na marami po siyang ginagawa na ikabubuti ng bayan pero ayaw tanggapin ng mga tao. We live up to you also, O Lord, ang we pray, Lord, dito sa Amerika, we pray, Lord, na magkaroon po ng wisdom ang mga tao na pag-aralan po nila ang mga plataforma ng mga leaders namin dito para maisaayos po ang sitwasyon ng bansa namin, Lord. We pray, O Lord, na give all the people the wisdom, give all the people the patience, give all the people the knowledge, and give all the people the time to study the platforms of all these leaders, O Lord. And we pray for a clean election, O Lord, this coming year, O Lord. Thank you, Lord, for all these prayer requests. We believe, Lord, you are in the one. You are the one in control of everything that is happening in the world. Siguro, Lord, nangangailangan po kami ng fasting. Fasting para magawa po namin at masolve lahat ng problema ito. Hindi lang po para sa ibang tao, kundi para rin po sa aming mga sarili. Thank you, Lord, and we pray that everything will come to pass, that you will be in control, you will take care of us, O Lord, that you will be giving us the wisdom as we move forward, O Lord, in the coming days, in the coming months. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Sister Fe. Tita Fe, you may start whenever amen. You're ready. Thank you.
Amen. Almighty God, the God of all nations, we come before you, O Lord God, asking for your mercy upon the whole world. God, you are our creator and savior, Jesus. There's no other way but you, Jesus. We thank you. We bless your name. We magnify your name. We praise you, Lord God, because you are above everything. You are the God of all gods, the God of all nations. And we bow down before you. We praise your name. We thank you, Lord, for the many things that you have done for your people. God, we thank you that you are a God who keeps your promises. You have promised us your love that never ends. You have promised us your protection that is always there wherever we are. And whatever happens around the world, you are there because you are faithful. We thank you for every provision that you have for us. We thank you for strength, for life, for breath of life, Lord. We thank you for everything that you are for us. And today, Lord God, we bow down before you with thanksgiving and praise and adoration. Lord God, we thank you for our shortcomings. Lord, we thank you for the blood of Jesus that covers us. For answered prayers, Lord, that we have given you, Lord, we have made. You answered our prayers and we praise you and thank you for them. We still have our breath of life and we are confident, Lord God, that you are in our midst no matter what is happening, O Lord. In this world, we are in the wilderness, COVID, Lord, hatred, anger, oh God, oh, and everything else happening around. This wilderness, oh God, we are in, we know that you are with us, you are present with us. And you have promised us, Lord God, that As long as we are connected to you in prayer and through your word, O Lord God, from moment to moment, you will never let any deadly disease to come nigh our homes. We thank you, Lord. And O God, this pandemic still, O Lord, is there. But we know that nothing happens by accident. There is a purpose for everything that happens, O God. And in the midst of that, Lord, we have you as our strength. Give us wisdom, give our leaders wisdom throughout the world, O God, and help the people to come to you. Lord God, there is an advantage in a pandemic like this. It can cause, if people will hearken to your voice, they will come to you. Holy Spirit of the Lord, convict your people across the world. People who have ignored you. People, even Christians who have taken you lightly. Lord, be with them. Draw all of us nigh to you with thanksgiving and praise and dependence on you and you alone. God, we thank you, Lord, for your healing power. We ask, O Lord, that you will come into the homes of those that, O God, with pandemic, with COVID-19. Lift them up, Lord. Stretch your hand of healing upon them. Touch their hearts, touch their bodies, touch everything that is that is involved in their lives, and may they know that they have hope in you. Help them to trust you and you alone, Jesus, Almighty God, through Jesus Christ. Lord God, you are greater than the pandemic. God, we lift up to you the frontliners and every family, Lord God, who is affected with COVID-19. Give your healing touch, for we know, dear Lord God, you died on the cross when you said, "It is finished." You have already given us the power to claim your healing power, both physically and spiritually. God, we thank you for being present in the midst. Across the world, you are greater than the pandemic. God, we lift up to you the Filipinos, the OFW, Lord, who are suffering, especially in Saudi Arabia. Their employees, O Lord, are cruel. They have treated, O Lord, our people like animals. They have driven them from their homes, from their dwelling, and they don't give them food. And our Filipinos, O God, are going to the garbage cans, O God, to eat some, to be able to find something to put in their stomach, O God. And their families in the Philippines are suffering, Lord, and there are children involved. O God, we lift them up to you. God, come down with your mercy upon them. God, Lord, and they are physically abused. O God, we lift them up to you. Help them, Lord, out of your mercy, we pray. We thank you, Lord, for deliverance. We ask that you will keep them, the children especially, oh God, with people around who can help them. Some of them have already died and get infected with COVID-19. Have mercy upon them, Lord. Oh God, we thank you. We lift up to you all the frontliners. We thank you for the blood that was shed on Calvary to cover them. We thank you, Lord, for by every stripe that you had on your way to Calvary meant, oh Lord, healing for them. You are greater than the pandemic. No weapon formed against any one of them, Lord, can prosper. We trust you. We thank you. You said, Lord, call upon my name and your heavenly Father will be glorified. And that means to say, you are hearing our prayers and you will answer them. Lord God, we thank you, Lord God, for your power across the world. You have a purpose, O God, and help us to listen to your voice. Help us to be guided by your will. Help us to be obedient to you. Help us to be connected to you so that we will have strength, we will have protection, we will have love, we will have life. And thank you for answering our prayers. And we thank you, Lord, for you said, for this is our confidence that you have heard our prayers and answered them, O God, with the desire of our hearts, Lord, that you will give, or you will receive our prayers, our request from the throne of glory, from the throne of grace. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Tita Fe. Heavenly Father, we continue to pray to you, Lord God. We just want to lift up your name up high, Lord God. You're worthy to be worshipped. You are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, Lord God. You are majestic, Lord God. Lord, if there's anything in our hearts, Lord God, that is unpleasant, not worthy, Lord God, in front of your throne, Lord, there's anything that we said, there's anything that we thought of, if there's anything that we did that is sinful, Lord God, we ask for forgiveness. We repent for our sins, Lord God. We ask that you continue to cleanse us, Lord God. And we just want to make our hearts right with you, Lord God. Lord, thank you. Thank you for everything that we receive from you, we're receiving from you, and we're about to receive from you. Thank you for your provisions, for your love, for your mercy, for your forgiveness, Lord God. Lord, we lift up to you our personal request, Lord God, as one family, as one church. We particularly, Lord God, lift up to you Brother Bong, who's a work environment, Lord God. We're praying for peace, Lord God. We're praying for love and understanding and orderliness within the work environment, that there will be no room for cursing, there will be no room for saying things that is unnecessary and not encouraging, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, that you keep Brother Bong to be as a unique as person as he is, in a sense that he will stand out, Lord God, because he will be the salt, designated salt and light in that workplace. And you will make use of him as a catalyst, Lord God, in that workplace. I pray for his protection. I pray for a change in environment, Lord God, in that workplace, Lord God. We believe that you can fill that place with your spirit, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for the praise report of Sister Fe Maranan and about her daughter, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that she's very okay now and everything is doing well. We pray for her chest x-ray tomorrow, that everything will be negative, Lord. We pray, Lord God, for COVID protection within her building, Lord God, that you put your blood, Lord God, in her doorpost, and that people who are COVID infected will heal as soon as possible, Lord God, by your miraculous healing hand, Lord God. And we pray for continuous protection for sisters by Marana, Lord God. We praise your name, Lord God, for the successful for Sister Madel, Lord God, for her chemo. We continue to pray for her chemo, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, that she's on her way, road to recovery, Lord God. And you will continue also to use this opportunity, Lord God, to speak, Lord God, in her heart and show how much you love her, Lord God. We also pray for Mommy, Lord God, about her UTI, about her something that she's feeling not well, Lord God. We pray that you continue to heal Mommy, Lord God. We continue to you keep on comforting her, Lord God, with your love, Lord God, with your word, Lord God. We also pray, Lord God, for we also pray, Lord God, for Sister Len in her place, Lord God. We pray for her safety and from the anarchy of homelessness, Lord God. We pray that that there will be peace in that place, Lord God, and you will continue to protect Sister Len. We pray for Pastor Bert, Lord God. We thank you for her rest day on Sunday, Lord God, and may it continue, Lord God, that he will be given a Sunday rest day, Lord God, for him to worship you, Lord God, and to serve you, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, also for him whenever he deal with the homelessness, with the homeless persons, Lord God. We lift up to you, Lord God, his son James, for another opportunity of work, Lord God, that we believe that you are the one who gives favor, Lord, sa amin, Panginoon. We pray for Tita Feldumok, Lord God. Her grandchildren are frontliners. They are heroes. We pray for their protection, Lord God. Thank you for the healing, Lord God, in their family. Thank you, Lord God, that as you continue to use them being for their heroic acts, Lord God, we pray that you bless them, Lord God. Bless them, Lord God, 100-folds of what they are doing right now, being frontliners, and as well as keep them protected, Lord God. We pray for Sister LV, Lord God. Her patient right now has a swelling problem. We pray, Lord God, that you continue to heal her, Lord God. You continue to make yourself reveal yourself to her, Lord God, in a sense that she will be grateful once you know, Lord God, that you're the healing God who heal her, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, for our workers, leaders, and all members meeting this coming Friday. We pray that everybody will be excited for our new directions. Everybody will be excited for as we have this new beginnings, Lord God, in spite of the what is happening with the pandemic. You are giving us hope in our hearts, Lord God, to do the ministry with gladness. We thank you, Lord God, for the reopening of our ministry in Silmar, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, first that everybody will be safe. Protect them, Lord God. I pray, Lord God, that you continue to use the leadership to bring the gospel of good news to those people who are in need in that area. We pray, Lord God, that you use Pastor Manny as he leads those people, Lord God, in your using your love, Lord God. We pray that that their reopening, Lord God, will be as successful, Lord God, as you plan it to be, Lord. I pray for protection. I pray, Lord God, that there will be no happening that there will be no things that will happen hindi niyo po iaalaw, Panginoon. We thank you, Lord, for the power prayer. We thank you, Lord, for everything, Lord God, that we're receiving from you, from all the results, all the testimonies, all the praise reports. We love you. In Jesus' name, amen. Pastor Manny.
Okay, let's pray. Lord, we come before you and we thank you for all of these prayers, and we acknowledge the answers to all of these prayers, and we believe in the power of prayer. And so we just declare, dear Lord, that you're in control of every prayer request, that it has been answered, O Lord God. Those who need healing will be healed. There will be peace and order upon our land, O Lord. There will be a stop to all of this epidemic, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. There will be a good election that will be coming, O Lord. You will just bless everyone, Lord, every person in this group, so that we will receive your blessing upon us, to be strong in the Lord, and we will always be healthy, and no epidemic will even touch us in the name of Jesus, because of the power of your word. Continue to use us, even as we declare that, Lord, you will give us this vision, this direction to keep on preaching the word of God in spite of the epidemic. We will be able to use available means necessary, the social media, and help us to be in one accord, to be able to make this, Lord, as a priority of sharing the gospel to people. And so we pray as we declare, oh Lord God, for peace in our land, peace in our hearts, in our family. We declare, dear Lord God, that you will just bless everyone, Lord, in our church, oh Lord, you will be declared, O Lord God, that you will be the one who will provide for all our needs, even those who are going through tough times, O Lord, in this epidemic. You are a great provider. We pray for your direction upon us. We pray for the knowledge, the wisdom that comes from the Lord. We thank you for the victory in Christ Jesus. We declare, dear Lord God, that we will just continue to shine as lights in this dark world. We declare for your financial provision upon us, O Lord. We thank you for all of these declarations of faith that comes from your word. And we pray that we will continue to look up to Jesus, being steadfast in our faith, enduring hardship for the sake of the knowledge of serving the Lord Jesus Christ as soldiers of the Lord. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance and give you peace. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
Amen and amen. Amen. Thank you. So it's nice
tonight our Bible study over Zoom. Okay.
Mm-hmm. 7 o'clock.
7 o'clock.
Invite more people.
Invite more people. And then please keep on calling our members so that they will join us this Friday and we will have one vision. We have not really changed our vision. The vision is to be able to share the gospel. We'll only change the way we strategize our vision.
Amen.
So we'll make more strategies as we go along. Okay, so please help us to be able to do it together.
Mr. Pagkiusa po, yung ano, yung padadala nyo si Ada o yung mga members natin, yung...
Oh, si Pastor.
Yung ano po, yung password nyo, ibigay niya rin po.
Apo, I don't think...
Ang gagawin natin sa Zoom, tatanggalin natin yung password at waiting room. So walang password, walang waiting room. Once they click the link, it will go directly. So it will be not hard for them to join.
Diretso na.
Wala na password.
Wala nang waiting room. Tapos kung kompleto na tayo, ilalock na natin. Wala nang makakapasok.
Anong text mamayang gabi?
Oh, teka, mabuti. Natanong mo ko. Continuation ng look. Ite-text ko lang sa inyo, no? Mm-hmm. Tapos na tayo sa Jericho, no? Ah, si Jericho. Si... Teka, ha? Sa Chaos?
Sa puno.
Oh, okay.
Sa Chaos.
Tapos na tayo dyan. So, continuation na. Okay. Yung matangkad, tapos na tayo.
Mamaya, 5 minutes from now, 10 o'clock, our Sunday sermon is about having a grip of God's greatness. So you can tune in to Facebook and YouTube Live. So, and then 7 o'clock with Pastor Manny, our Bible study, Sunday Bible study. Ayan. Huwag natin kalimutan mag-invite, mag-like, mag-share.
Okay. The topic tonight is the parable of the 10 minas.
10 minas.
Yeah, verses 11 to...
Pastor, Luke what?
Luke chapter 19, 11 to...
Luke chapter 19?
Yes.
Luke chapter 19, verses what?
11 to 19.
11 to 19. Luke 19, 11 to 19?
Yes, yes. Parable of the 10 minas. Please invite others along. We will have a wonderful discussion of this.
Yung minas.
Minas, yung ano, yung...
Pera, talent.
Oh, the talent. Parang parable of the talents. Minas.
Okay.
Okay. Somebody was sharing kanina? Ikaw, sir?
I'm saying, ang LA First Church, I think I saw them live. But I keep on praying na sana makamit na rin tayo on basis na kahit 10 tao lang, at least you could start the church soaring high slowly para ma-prepare din yung place. I think it's but proper sa akin lang, ha, kasi naalala ko yung sa Exodus 23:25 that the Lord will send his angels ahead of us. and preparing the place for us. So I think that's what we do in preparation for the opening. We have to really intercede, and then we really have to sanctify the place and dedicate the place once more. So when we breathe the air there, it would be clean and everything would be sanctified according to the Lord. We really desire that could really start off and not fearing because of, I know everybody's fearful about the COVID, but you know what? We have been faced, akin lang experience namin na. I've been working in the lab for more than, 30 years, but never had I seen any medical technologies infected with this virus of anything like AIDS or any other viruses. Because we are fully committed to protect ourselves. So in our mind is, our mindset namin is laging on safety. I think that's what we do. We really have to have a mindset of safety and imposing to ourselves the real precautionary measures. So sa akin lang, we can start slowly with few people. Arranging the place 6 feet apart with a mask and hand sanitizer. Not touching anything on your face. You will be protected. Kasi with the distance na malayo, there's no chance the virus could be transmitted with the barrier sa mouth mo. Kasi ang transmission is in the nasal cavity at saka sa mouth. So I am hoping na we will be educated by this para ma-overcome natin yung fear. Kasi pag hindi na, ako, I'm diabetic. I'm really prone to this infection, but I'm trusted na yung ginagawa kong personal protection sa sarili ko at saka to other people would really bring us to a great delight of really meeting together. So, but, kung hindi pa ready yung iba, the other people are ready, I think we can start it off. But if the longer we linger, the longer people would be lazy to come to church. So that's my observation. So I'm hoping we could really think about it.
Amen. Amen. So any parting words? We have last 1 minute before our Facebook Live.
Start.
So we're good.
Pastor.
Go ahead.
Yeah. Hindi ba tayo pwede magkaroon ulit ng fasting for the year?
I think we failed this year, no? Hindi natin nagawa yan this week. This, usually we do it summertime.
Ano po yan? Fasting?
Prayer and fasting.
Fasting.
Yeah, we do it, Pastor. Yung iba 21 days, iba 7 days, iba partial fasting, iba full fasting. Ginagawa natin every year.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Hindi natin nagawa this year. Siguro we can. It's not too late yet. We can do it.
Yeah. We can start, for instance, one day every Sunday.
Mm. Or after every prayer night, tayo. Or morning. Depends on inyo, basta mag-pray lang.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Sunday after prayer or Sunday before the whole Sunday. Mm-hmm. Let's plan that out as part of our strategy for Friday. Yeah. Arrange natin yan.
Yep.
Prayer and fasting for the church.
Siguro.
Okay, so Pastor Jeff will be that's a good aspect. We'll have communion. Okay, we'll have virtual communion. Okay, so why don't we do it next week, ano?
Mm-hmm. Or tonight?
Announce
ko na lang Friday so that we will have communion. Mas mabuti para alam nila. So we will put that. Sige, kung anong pa mga suggestion nyo, please tell Pastor Jeff about it. I-consolidate niya lahat sa ating PowerPoint.
Live na si Pastor.
Happy birthday. You attend
We are now listening to Pastor Jeff.
Okay, bye guys. See ya.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
Happy Sunday.
Happy Sunday. Bye.